I love a toner. Hey guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So this has been asked for such a long time on TikTok, and I've been putting off doing it because I've never really been into skincare. I've only recently got into skincare since I've been doing the influencing thing, and I have seen a difference in my skin. So I feel like it is time to share my morning skincare versus my nighttime skincare routine with you all. But before I go ahead with the video, can you please just make sure you like and subscribe, and also follow me on my socials, LucyAppleton21 on Instagram and TikTok. But yeah, so I'm literally just gonna show you my morning skincare routine versus my nighttime skincare routine. I just got out of the shower. Good morning. So I got up, I did a workout, I've had breakfast, just been in the shower. So I'm gonna take you through like my morning routine. I do tend to like shower more on the morning, especially if I've like done a workout. So yeah, I'll show you what I do. Just a side note, not for like my face, but I do moisturize my whole body with this Garnier Gradual Tan Summer Body. This just keeps like my olive skin glowing a tiny little bit in the winter months. So yeah, that's what I use on my body. But for my face, so in the shower, I use this just Asda Tea Tree Facial Wash. It comes out like really foamy, and then I just literally, I use what this, it was like £3 from Primark, so I always just like exfoliate with this side and like massage in with this side on my face, and that just makes my skin feel really nice and soft, smooth, really cleans it. When I get out of the shower, I then go in with this 3-in-1 mask, scrub and cleanser. Again, it's just from the Asda Tea Tree range. I found it's really nice on my skin because it includes that moisturizer as well. It's just really helping with the softness, but obviously washing my face. So I just pop about that amount on my hand and just wet it with some water, like so. I just rub it in, especially on my cheeks, which are like my more acne prone areas, and my chin, like so. As I'm washing it off, I just like massage it with water. And just do this for a few minutes before then just completely washing it off. Making sure it does get in. You can really feel the scrub with this as well, which is good. I like it when you have a scrub and you can really feel it, like actually scrubbing. You feel like it's actually doing something. And then I just go off and wash it off with some water. I normally have like music blasting at this point, but I'm sharing it with you guys today. I need to sort my hair out completely. I'm gonna be like, why did I do a YouTube video and like not at least sort my hair out before filming it? But this is me. But for those guys that haven't watched my hair care routine yet, this is day 4, and it's, look at how much volume my hair has still got. And obviously I haven't washed it yet, and this is still the volume, still the level of curl. I haven't even actually styled this yet. This is still from the rollers. So definitely worth watching my hair care routine if you're someone that does want to train your hair for only washing it once a week, what sorts of products and things I do use to get this volume. Anyway, so then once I've done that, I then just go in with my Simple toner. So it's Soothing Facial Toner from Simple, Cotton Wool Pad. And I saw this thing on TikTok where you just do it in like a motion of 3, and then use the other side, do it in a motion of 3, because you're not wanting to get the dirt, like go back on yourself and get the dirt. So I just do the motion of 3, literally that's it for my morning time. I then moisturize. Now for my morning moisturize, I do normally just pop on the Garnier Summer Body on top as well. Just to, obviously, because I'm doing it to my skin every single day, I just pop it on in the morning on my face, but just a tiny little bit, and then I like moisturize properly on an evening time. When I say a tiny bit, I literally just get the tiniest bit in the morning. And just pop it on my face. it. That is my morning routine that I do every single day to my face. I'll see you again this evening after a full day of filming, taking my makeup off and showing you what I actually do on an evening time. But yeah, that is my morning skincare routine. Hey guys, so nighttime routine. So I've just obviously had a full day of filming, got full face of my makeup on, which I cannot wait to get off. But firstly, what I do first and what I actually cannot wait for, because I've had them in all day, is to take my contact lenses out. If you're someone that, like me, that does wear contact lenses, once you've had them in all day, you just start to feel them and they get all heavy. And you just want them out. So firstly, let's do that. And then I'll show you what I do to get my makeup off and the skincare products that I've been using. As I said, I am using the Mario Badescu. A lot of people have said they don't rate it, so I am going to order something new for when this stuff has run out. But it's actually not really irritating me that much. And I feel like it's all right, so yeah. Anyway, right, so now I've got that, take the lashes off. That is another really great feeling. I'll pop them in my makeup room after. So I have this like reusable tape, like cloth for taking my makeup off. I use it about 3 times and then I chuck it in the wash. This is going to be the 3rd time, so it definitely does need a wash. But yeah, I just literally cover this in warm water and then give it a good squeeze out and put some micellar water on. I use the Garnier micellar cleansing water. So I just put that on my cloth and wipe it off. I do my hair ties, check my nails. Like so. Isn't that like the best feeling in the world, just getting your makeup off after like all day wearing it? Do we literally though, I always do this, I always just look at the difference, I'm like, whoa. I honestly, I'm so happy I've started using a cloth though, because I used to literally go through about like 7 or 8 like cotton wool pads to take my makeup off, and it's just an unnecessary amount. And I say that, like, I literally just wash this after using it 3 times. So much more sustainable. And I actually feel like my skin's improved since using it. I don't know why. I just feel like it has. Once I've rinsed it out for the 2nd time, I don't put more micellar water on it. I just keep going. This is just mainly to get like most of your makeup off. And then I do go in with just a couple of pads. I know I've just said it's sustainable, but I feel like it's a lot better than the 7 or 8 that I used to use. But I do just like to go over it with a couple of pads and some cleanser just to feel like I did get it all. So yeah, I just get then 2 extra pads and some more of this Garnier micellar water, and I just pop it on. If one's enough, then that's fine. I just then like to give it a good rub and make sure I got it all off, because I do put a lot of makeup on when I'm filming. Once that is done, I then get 1 more. So I feel like in my whole nighttime routine, I have limited this to 3 pads. And it used to be a good 10 with everything. So quite proud of myself. I'll eventually get to none, hopefully. But it's better than wipes, so we're okay. So then I go in with this simple soothing facial toner, the same one that I use in the morning time. I just feel like this is really nice on your skin. Oh, I feel so good. I love a toner. Then I just literally wait for that to dry. I then obviously, it's not a face mask night for me, but I do like 2x a week in this routine. At this stage, I would then put a face mask on and then I would wash the face mask off and go with what I'm about to show you. But I will show you some face masks that I do use. I actually have been using this Coco Wow from Hello Body for actually quite a long time now, since last summer. It's all vegan, like cruelty free, so it's a really good like product. The smell is amazing. This one, what I absolutely love about this is that it literally absorbs into your skin, so you actually look, you don't look like you're wearing a mask at all. And like, people would never guess that you were wearing a mask after you've had it on for about a few minutes. It literally absorbs all into your skin. So that's what I love about that, because I'm like, it's definitely getting in there, which is what I want. And then this one is from the Mario Badescu set, acne prone set. I've only used this once just because I've been using that one and I'm waiting for it to run out. But I honestly was, the smell is not great, I'm not gonna lie. But I was so shocked at how like it washed off really nicely, it set really nicely on my face. I was like so shocked at how nice it was, bearing in mind people had told me that they weren't really impressed with the brand and how badly the smell was when I put it on. That is the only thing. So if you, but you, after a few minutes you don't smell it, but it really sits well on your face, which, so I really liked it. So that's what I've been using for masks. Yes, after I've toned, I go in with my acne treatment. Now this is from Dermatica. I did actually put a TikTok up about this. I'm like a month and a half way through. It's a 3 month treatment. Mainly just targeting my like cheek areas where I get the acne. Don't know if you can see. So I'm going to see now if this actually gets rid of it. But I just literally use one pump of this, and when my face is completely dry from the toner, I just go over my acne areas, because this can, they do personalize it to you, but I said I had oily skin, which I do have oily skin in a lot of places, but this like really does dry your skin out, so I do only put it over my like oily acne prone areas, just because I don't want the other areas of my skin to dry out. So I just get a good amount all over my spotty areas. Then I go in with these products, which I'll show you. So I use the Mario Badescu oil-free moisturizer. And I just use a little squeeze of this. This, for everyone saying that this is bad, I actually live for the moisturizer. I haven't actually shown the cleanser in this video. It really depends. Like, I normally do actually put that on an evening, but today I just went with the Garnier micellar water because I'm literally going to get up and shower in the morning. But if I wasn't going to get up and shower, I would have definitely used the Mario Badescu, just because I feel like that's more of like a facial wash, which is really good. So I haven't actually had a problem with those products personally. But yeah, so I go in with this moisturizer. Now I mix it with some of the Ordinary Vitamin C. Now this has actually proven really, really harsh under my eyes. And I did actually get some like, not like scars, but it was actually like burning here a little bit. So now I just put like the tiniest little drop in with my moisturizer. And I just avoid my under eyes, and then after I've moisturized, I then go in with this under eye cream from Superdrug, which is the Naturally Radiant under eye brightening eye cream. This Mario Badescu set, if you are interested, although no one seems to be, it's £27 from Beauty Bay. That's how much I would just put on. £27 from Beauty Bay. Obviously, they come quite small, I think, but. And then this Ordinary Vitamin C. I just do this, I feel like I do want like glowing cheeks and glowing forehead skin. I literally just honestly get the tiniest little amount and mix them together, just because obviously for me personally I have experienced it burning a little bit, and I just avoid the under eyes. I love rubbing in a good, like, having a good moisturize on an evening, feeling like I'm giving my skin some goodness. It is a bit of a sharp tack. At first I thought it was the moisturiser, but I tried them separately and it is the vitamin C. So it is a little bit of a sharpness, but it's not too bad, and it literally does go after about a minute. I don't know whether vitamin C is maybe good for my skin type. I'm not someone that's really researched into this. I just know that it helps give you glowy skin, which is what I want. And then I go in with this Naturally Radiant Superdrug Own Brightening Eye Cream. I've actually had no problems with this. I know it's Superdrug Own, but I really liked it, and it's lasted me ages. It really does do the job, and it hydrates my under eyes.
I know nothing's gonna literally get rid of the bags unless it's sleep. So I feel like this really helps hydrate them. If I was doing a face mask, I would have put the eye masks on as well afterwards, just to give them a little refresh. But on a night like tonight, I just like to put this under eye cream on, which gives them a good like brightening feel in the morning after the cream has like settled in all overnight. So that's it cream wise. I then just chuck on my Nivea Lipsol, because my lips do get really dry, especially this time of year in winter. It's literally just Nivea. I just love it when my lips feel super soft. And that is literally it. I have maybe left out a couple of products, as I've explained, but it's just the way that this has fallen the day that I'm filming this. As I definitely learn more about skincare, definitely learn a bit more about my skin type, I'm gonna obviously adapt my routine. And so if I find better products, if I find something better that's working for me, if you guys have any tips, I'll definitely do an updated like morning and nighttime skincare routine for you. But yeah, if you're someone that's new to it like me, I hope this has helped a little bit and maybe just even made you think, yeah, I should probably get into skincare. If you are someone that's really into skincare, please don't judge me. Just kindly give me feedback or any suggestions that you have. That would be amazing. But yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Just another like chatty beauty style video. I do have a makeup tutorial and my hair care routine. I will actually be posting an updated makeup tutorial soon, which will be good. But yeah, I have loads of other videos. If you like what you see, please hit that subscribe button and I will see you in the next video.